What's up, family? How's everybody doing tonight? Let me switch up mics, man. I got a lot of choices up here. What's that?
Feeling very good tonight. Feeling very good. You know, it's a blessing to be here with you guys. You know what I'm saying? And spreading this love and being here with these beautiful people. All you guys, I appreciate you for taking your time out, you know, to come talk to me and to hear me speak and, you know, be a part of this history tonight, you know? And, you know, I definitely took a lot of time out, you know, to figure out what I was going to come and talk about today and bring awareness to it. You know, just make sure I come here to settle your minds, because number one thing is, you know, we have come very far, and we should all be appreciative and pat yourselves on the back. And thank you to the University of Florida and the beautiful staff, you know what I'm saying, and the school. You guys have a wonderful university. And, you know, this is testament to how far we are coming, you know, just as people, as a community. You know, this is just amazing. So, you know, thank you for all the support, supporting me and such like that. So, you know, I definitely made a quote for you guys that is personal for UF that I thought about and I wanted to bring to you. And it says this: we deserve the right to live. We deserve the right to love. And thank you, thank you. You know, so how my style is, you know, and my vibe, man, you know, I like that. But you know how my style is and kind of my personality is, I'm very, yes. thank you. You know, I like to segue a lot. There's a lot of things on my mind, you know, like I'm always switching up, you know, subjects, because it's a lot of things that I do want to speak about. And as you see, I do have a lot of notes for you guys that I personally wanted to talk about. Something I care about. So, you know, hopefully we'll be able to get through as much as possible in a timely fashion and, you know, just give everything to you guys that I was thinking about and I was writing about. But I think the first thing, you know, coming to my mind was talking about traditions and transitions and, you know, from all the knowledge that we are acquiring, you know, there's a lot of stuff that has been going on. And it's a beautiful, you know, transition that we're actually in right now. Like, for us to be able to be doing this, for you guys to be supporting an unsigned, you know, independent artist like myself, who really is doing this 100% by myself, you know, no backing, no corporate backing, really just me by myself. So, you know, it's just a really special time on earth, and, you know, this is a really beautiful time to be alive, you know, not just because of me, not just because of us, but just because this is just a cool time to be alive right now, you know? It's just, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna lie, man. It's a great time, to be totally honest. So, you know, I definitely think we all need to really just make sure we continue to pat ourselves on the back about that and realize how special this time is and, you know, how special your time is as human beings and whatever you feel that you are, you know what I'm saying? Definitely your time is extremely special and this is just a great time on earth. So, you know, I'm definitely extremely humble about that. And, you know, it's just super positive, you know? It's super positive. So with that, we're coming to about comparing yourself, you know what I'm saying? And making sure, you never try to compare yourself to someone's outside, you know? So never compare your personal excellence or your inside or judge yourself for someone's exterior. You get what I'm saying? Like, And what I mean by that is, like, you know, because we all have our exterior shells, our personalities, you know what I'm saying? Or like, or you know, how we represent ourselves. But then we have our inside feelings. And, you know, we all are a victim of judgment, prejudice, and stuff like that. And I know it's super hard to always get over that and to switch up and to, you know, change your thoughts, which you were, you know, with these thoughts were just, you know, continuously fed to us, and, you know, we've seen it over and over. So it's crazy to sometimes have to retrain yourself to think, even though you guys are doing this, and that's why I respect it, because you guys are learning daily, pushing your minds and pushing yourselves to the maximum. And, you know, I really respect that a lot. It's not easy to do what you guys are doing. So please always take a deep breath, you know what I'm saying, and congratulate yourself. Treat yourself by, you know, drinking water, taking care of yourself.
Thank you, Mr. Scott.
You feel me? You know, yeah, definitely treat yourself, you know what I'm saying? Like, whatever makes you feel good, don't, you know, don't live for somebody else. You know, if you think picking flowers and sitting at the tree is what makes you happy, you know what I'm saying? Like, do that, you know what I'm saying? And don't feel bad about that, you know what I'm saying? I definitely have my things that make me happy, you know what I'm saying? And I like taking long walks, you know what I'm saying? I love taking long walks.
Long walk passport.
Yes. And so, you know, I don't compromise. And, you know, really what it is, I love actually taking long walks by myself. So, you know, that's a big thing. And a lot of people are like, why do you do that? You know, why do you want to do that? And, oh, they add that. So I actually take long walks by myself at nighttime. So, you know, people really think I'm crazy. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's just a, you know, a big, 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 you know, you just live how you live, man. And, you know, with living, we're always figuring out, you know, what is our purpose of living? You know, why are we here? You know, trying to figure out what, you know, we are here for on this life, on this earth, you know what I'm saying? And definitely, for me, I feel like, first thing, us realizing the common that we have, just all being in here together, which is a beautiful thing. We're all coming in here, you know, to hear me speak, and as well as to hear something new, which is automatically, so everybody in here can automatically be like, okay, we have something in common, because obviously, if you came here tonight, you're obviously a forward thinker, or you're cool, or you're open-minded, or, you know what I'm saying? And something, you know what I mean? Something is cool about you and different. So that's why I love you too. So many different ways of living and ways that we need to live our life and we get told how we need to live our life. And, you know, with me choosing to become an artist and an entertainer, as well as putting love through music, because the core foundation of why I even make music is because I know that music has the power to connect and connect people, to heal, to help, to invoke emotions. It's an art form to me. And it's something that you study. I'm inspired by life. I'm inspired by people. You know, I really take everything just and I soak it in, you know, from this is music to me, and I get inspired by that, from that little sound that, you know what I'm saying? Everything I'm taking bits and pieces from. You know, and it's like, it's clinging to me like I'm a magnet, you know what I'm saying? It's like clinging on my body, I'm so big.
You're my magnet!
I love it, but
you know, I'm just soaking things in, man. And I'm a woman, you know what I'm saying? And, make sure we don't leave anybody out. You know what I'm saying? That's the only thing. No one deserves to feel left out. You know, we want to always include and make sure everybody understands that they are welcome no matter what type of words. You know, because we stop by words, you know, words stop us, you know, or groups stop us. You know, we got to make sure to know that, hey, you are welcome in my group. The group is for everybody to be in, you know. You know, regardless of whatever, if you feel like you want to be in our group, I think you damn well be in there, speaking to person. But why I really make music is just because I understand the power of, you know, words and putting words together and getting into a zone where things really just become fluid and very natural to you because you've been practicing it for a while, you know, either practicing positivity or practicing music and stuff like that. So my goal for music, I didn't come into music to make money, and that can either be a good or a bad thing, you know what I'm saying? But my, and a good or bad thing to who perceive it, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like my billionaire rapper, doing whatever the billionaires do. I was just like, I want to make music because it makes me smile, it makes me feel good. I know it makes other people feel good. People like when I rap, and it makes me feel good that people acknowledge me and give me praise for something that I love to do. And I think that's important that we always remember that, you know, people yearn for praise, people yearn to be accepted. You know, I think we all deserve to be accepted. And to make sure that no one is being rejected for how they want to live. As much as we feel that this is right and this is wrong, you know, we need to make sure that, you know, we all treat each other equally. Make sure, you know, and that's a broad thing to say, treat each other equally, because everybody's life is a special case. I think we deserve to listen to it and, you know, just figure out the best way to interpret that message. But, you know, making sure also, as I come to music and saying like that, you know, not being in it for the money and stuff like that, I think a big thing is also to make sure when you do acquire wealth and, you know, money and things from your hard work and for you loving what you do, hopefully, and I think everybody should, if they're not, work to transition and have that hole in the back burner and making sure you find that thing that you love to do, regardless of what it is, you know, regardless of petty or not, or whatever it is, you know, you find that thing that you love to do. But make sure you don't also hoard the wealth, or, you know, make sure, you know, you don't hurt these other people to make sure that you get paid. That's one thing I have a lot of pride in myself, and thank you. I have a lot of pride in is not, you know, I've never stepped on anybody, and you know, that's like a figure of speech or whatever, but I feel like I've never, you know what I'm saying? I haven't stepped on anybody because I'm not a rock, you know what I'm saying? I'm a rock, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I feel good just with my ethics of business and how I feel about my business and how I feel about Lil B. Is that, you know, I just feel really good. Like, hey, I earned my money in a very honest and, you know, just a good way to be what I think. And, you know, just with integrity of my business, not compromising myself, which is a huge thing. And, you know, I go to sleep at night, I feel good. I don't feel like I'm not laughing. It's like, ha ha ha, you know, I actually, you know what I'm saying? Like, ha ha, I just made a deal. You know what I mean? Like, I actually feel really good because, like, I know that my core foundation is love. I'm spreading love, and people tell me this is a testament to love, and, you know, and just a lot of other things, you know. So for me, it always feels good to just get the truth, you know what I'm saying, and know why you are in the, you know, the line of work that you're doing or your future goals, you know, continue to rock with those. Also, it's crazy. Sometimes, how many people are afraid of hard work? Physical. I know this is hard work, but y'all doing physical hard work. I am sometimes, I can lie, you know what I'm saying? Like, look, man, I just did the hot pots thing where, you know, you cook, and I feel like I was doing a big thing. I'm like, man, I'm cooking. But I'm just so sensitive because I know I'm kind of ashamed of meat, you know what I'm saying? And eating meat is just not that good. And I'm ashamed of it. And I'm sensitive to the people that do not eat it, as well as it's just, you know, I always am just like, man, you know, I wish I was just born with a set of different tools and different mindset. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know what I mean? It's like, oh man, we're so used to this. You know what I'm saying? It's like, God, you know, we're going out of it, and me accepting other mindsets, you know, opening up, learning about different people has helped me so much, and to be more humble about things and making sure when I do speak about things, I'm not only thinking about myself, but thinking about everybody else that might be listening and that care about people, but that just care about, you know, people in general. And I guess, like, you know, people being afraid of toil and work hard and that physical hard work, you know, sometimes it gets in the mix of, you know, your regular work, you know. And I definitely think I'm a victim of that sometimes, where, you know, you don't want to, you want to be able to do both, you know what I'm saying? It's cool to be physical, it's cool to, you know, get your hands dirty and do, you know what I mean by that is, you know, grow your own, you know, vegetables, you know what I'm saying? Like, very lucky to be at UF, you know what I'm saying? You guys are a very special class and a very, you know, small percentage of people that ever will be able to get in here, you know what I'm saying? So definitely, I understand that you guys, out of anybody, know what our work is. I'm definitely big about just, you know, using your mind, as well as, once again, I need to be, you know, listen to what I'm saying. That's what I've been working on more, is, you know, personal hard work, because it feels good. You know, like, I climbed up a ladder to work on a property, you know what I'm saying? Like, I almost hurt myself, but I was like, usually I'm like, hey, you know, I'm just pay somebody, you know what I'm saying? They'll do their job. But is that the healthy way to think? You know what I'm saying? Like, think about it like that. I'm gonna pay somebody to do their job. Is that healthy? You know what I'm saying? And as long as I'm thinking about it in a, you know, that I'm actually trying to support that person. You get what I'm saying? And not just like, hey, this person's this, and I'm paying them and let them get away and let them fall and do whatever they're gonna do, hopefully they're insured. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? But, you know what I'm saying? Like, I paid you, you know what I'm saying? So you know, we just wanna make sure we're thinking of it in a healthy way. Like, I'm actually trying to support, you know, local business, you know, people in my community, you know what I'm saying, support the local businesses. And businesses in general, you know, I think we should support local as well as everybody. I think anybody that is trying to do something, we should at least listen and figure out what we can take from that in a positive way of learning and support them. You know, we all deserve to be supported in here.
I feel like I'm being supported right now, and it feels amazing. And thank you. You know, and it comes down to, you know, mutual aid and care for each other, you know what I'm saying? And supporting each other, it feels so good. And I will never be able to communicate that enough, and I'll always be able to, you know, continue to speak on that and push that, you know, like we need to support each other, you know, care about each other, you know, we are together. And, you know, and it sounds funny and cheesy sometimes, you know what I'm saying? It really doesn't, you know what I'm saying? Like, I really say, I think it actually sounds pretty cool. It just has to be, we have to be able to internalize it, you know what I'm saying? Like, it has to be internalized, and you have to continuously hear this, like, okay, we gotta work together, I gotta, you know, support my whoever, I don't know this person, but I wanna learn about them. You know, I need to decipher the message. And that's something that I always really love to speak about, is deciphering the message. You catching the message, you know, you figuring out the person that you're talking to and trying not to judge them, but also just trying to hear where they're coming from and why they're coming from that position. And, you know, I think that is a big, big thing. And with that, sometimes we are scared, you know. I think there's a lot of different levels of fear. Fear of being rejected, fear of not being accepted, whatever. I'm trying to hear y'all, you know what I'm saying? And if you got something to say, I'm gonna listen. But, you know, yeah, fear of being rejected is, like, that's a crucial thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, think about it, like, if you try to do something and you know, like, everybody's gonna make fun of you, or people are, you know, your core friends, or, you know, people that you respect, or, you know, a job, or, you know, something, like, people are gonna be mean to you because of that, or treat you differently, you know, it definitely affects how you think about things. Just imagine a world like this where you had no boundaries on your goals. What would you really be doing right now? You know what I'm saying? Like, think about it, if you didn't judge yourself on anything, nobody else did, there was nothing that you couldn't do, what would you be doing? You know what I'm saying? And that's something for you to think about, like, what would you be doing if you could do anything, which you really can, but just think about that, you know what I'm saying? What would you be doing? And, it just makes you think. It makes you think, like, what would I really be doing? And it's a lot of ideas. I got a lot of goals, and I feel like I'm definitely going towards them. And I'm, you know, making small steps towards the big goals that I want to complete. And there's nothing wrong with small steps. There's nothing wrong with setting goals in your mind and then putting them on paper. Just being able to be around these individuals and learn why they are, who they are, and acting how they are. And kind of take some of their personality and put it into mine. You know, I got a little bit tougher, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, you know, tougher, you know what I'm saying? You know, like, I definitely, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel, you know, so you take the good, you know, you try to take the good from it. We don't have to agree on everything, you know. We don't have to agree on how they handle problems or how they handle situations. But I know that me being myself, they take the good from me too. And, you know, as well as they listen to me. And people should listen to you, and you, as you lead by example. You know, I lead by example.
Shout out to the staff that's made this possible, you know what I'm saying? And University of Florida, go Gators, baby. Any questions?
Give it up one more time. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're just gonna step up to the mic one at a time. some questions for the bass guy, so let's go ahead and get started.
Hey. Hello.
Hey, what's up?
Yo, I'm a big fan, Bass Scott.
Thanks,
it's a pleasure to be like talking to you right now.
Thank you, man.
I kind of, for time's sake, I'll just ask one simple question. Can you please cook for me?
Oh, man, come on.
Just a little one.
Come on. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
I got two questions. One, would it be alright with the staff and the officers if I came up and took a selfie with you?
Yeah.
And two, what is your current opinion on the public school education system?
First, yes, you can come take a selfie. Second, public school education system, I think definitely we should focus more on the arts. I think that was an amazing school. I think it was elementary, and it lasted with me forever. I mean, I did my first poem on stage there, which transferred to me being comfortable on stage, getting rid of stage fright. I mean, we did numerous dance classes. You know, we slept overnight on a shift. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, I'm in elementary school, so I mean, all of this just, and I was super scared. I mean, we had to cook on there. I was actually on the deckhand crew. You know what I'm saying? This was like elementary, so I mean, you know, I think definitely we need to continue to focus on the arts and pay teachers way more. We need to make sure that, you know what I'm saying? Teachers, staff, anybody that's involved with education, education needs to be a super, publicized and just a super cool job to do, and that we need to, you know, honor and continue to honor the education system because it is important, and as well as giving students individual time as much as possible, because the teachers that did help me out and show me that extra love when I was acting out in high school, because I used to do things to kind of like act out, like especially when I would raise my hand and the light was on me. You know, I was like, ooh, like everybody's looking. Like that's when I can like say something or make everybody laugh or be the class clown or be the bad kid or do whatever, you know, because I love that attention, and that's what transferred from me to going into music. But what really stuck out was the teachers that understood and really sat back for me and said, you know what, Brandy, like you're super smart, like a history teacher of mine. English. She made me love English, you know what I'm saying? Because of how she took her time out to really care about me and, you know, support me individually, as well as another teacher of mine at Albany High, and Mr. Turner, very supportive. And, yeah, I love teachers that love their job, even though it's extremely stressful. I can only imagine what they go through, but, you know, please give the students that individual love that we need. What's up, man? How you doing?
Yo, turn around.
Yes.
Okay, we got to.
Yeah. Thank you, Bass Guy.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. I had a question for you. It's actually an ask. It's not for me, but it's for someone I really love. She's currently going through a lot right now. We were just at the Waka Flocka Flame concert on the
day. Yeah,
and someone apparently elbowed her in the head, and she's now dealing with a concussion, so she's on bed rest and couldn't actually be here. And you are her favorite rapper. She was really, really upset that she had to miss this. She's also dealing with a lot of stuff at home, too, in her home life with school, and also her mother's battling breast cancer right now. So I wanted to know if, I know this isn't the Make-A-Wish Foundation or anything, so you can't like go to her apartment and actually surprise her or anything like that, but I was hoping maybe after all these people were done with their questions, we can maybe do a video on the side of you just saying hi to her, maybe saying something inspirational, because she really is just upset she wasn't able to be here tonight.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.